and welcome to Pursuit of Perfect System. My name's Terry Ellis. I'm an audio reviewer, Dirac Live calibrator, and obviously first-class dancer. In this video, I'm doing a song demonstration as part of the review for the Mono Audio Platinum PL100 Mark IIs. And in this video, I'm getting nostalgic. That doesn't mean I'm going back to the 70s or the 60s because I wasn't around back then. This nostalgic for me. The rest of you can like it or lump it. When I, years ago, I think it's actually when I had Monitor Audio Gold speakers, the GX or Gold, I can't remember which ones they were. I made a few YouTube videos, this is back years ago, and put them on YouTube and stuff, and they've had 20 or 30 or 40,000 views and stuff like that. Unbelievable, really, for the quality of the video is terrible, quality sounds terrible. One of the songs I used to demonstrate the system at the time was a Lindsey Stirling Crystalize. I think I was using Gold speakers and a BKXLS 400 subwoofer, and sounded all right, to be honest. Sounded all right. Didn't sound bad. It sounded all right. But obviously, the terrible recording equipment I used meant that the sound quality of that video is terrible. Nowadays, I use really good quality recording equipment. So the sound of these YouTube videos is about as good as you're going to get anywhere across here. I don't think I can get any more sound quality across through the medium. Obviously, the better kit comes in here, the better the sound's going to come across. But I don't think I can really use any more better quality equipment, is what I'm trying to say. Not for this, not for what happens to it beyond this. So anyway, that's a buy point. So we're going to play Lindsey Stirling Crystalize. And the reason I'm going to play that is because that's an extreme test of everything in this system, really. Everything in the room. Because it's a sort of, it's a very compressed and artificial sounding song. But it's just got tons of everything in it. Whatever that's called, that instrument. Tons of violin, I think she plays, doesn't she? Tons of bass, all processed. Now, while that's good and bad for some people, it is a real test of the system. Test the timing, test the dynamics. Can it cope with the intensity of the sound? How well does the amplifier control the speakers? How well do the speakers deliver, you know, that intense experience which it's supposed to be? How well do they deliver that hugely deep bass? How well do bookshelf speakers deliver a throaty deep bass, and can they keep up with the rest of it? Now I'm going to show you a little clip which I've only filmed on my phone, so the quality is going to be rubbish, but look at the drivers. Obviously I do a sound check before. Look at the drivers, look how much the drivers are going off of the Mighty Mouse. The Mighty Mouse is seriously mighty, hence the nickname Mighty Mouse. That is obviously the nickname that I've created for, affectionately, I don't mind, for the Lima Acoustics Elements integrated amplifier, because it's very small. Yeah, it's unbelievable in way it drives speakers. Look at the way they're going. Look at the way they're going. It's unbelievable. So, yeah, the Mighty Mouse, obviously these are 4-ohm speakers, got 110 watts. A boy to kick it out. What a great, great, great little amplifier. A great little amplifier. So, right, let's have a listen to the song. I'm going to get be at the back of the room being all nostalgic, probably shed a tear. And if anybody says this doesn't sound as good as a video I created years ago, then I'm going to instantly delete you from the channel. That's just a joke, by the way. So here we go. Thank you. Mighty Mouse. Right then, no one can ever accuse me of playing it safe when it comes to song demonstrations. Like going to a hi-fi show, I play songs that test the system. And the thing about how difficult that is to try and record, you've got masses of bass and loads of stuff going on. So just factor that in when you listen to that. Recording easygoing music's much easier than recording intense music like that. Just think about what we're trying to record there, that amount of bass. And think about the amount of bass from bookshelf speakers. I think, again, that song highlights really the strengths and weaknesses of the system to a degree, and the PL100s. I wish I still had a Chord Dave in here. That extra resolution, especially bass control and clarity you get from the Chord Dave by compare with the Cutest, will just get more out of the speakers. I know it would. But at this price point, people are probably going to be pairing it up more likely with a Cutest or a Hugo 2 TT, maybe. So technically, it's probably a better test. But if I still had the Dave, I think we'd be getting a much more resolved sound. This is obviously, if everything's a bit soft and squidgy with the Cutest, it just doesn't have the tapulent filters. It just doesn't resolve the sound like the Dave does. The Dave is exquisite in that regard. But factoring all that in, it's impressive performance, really. And it's impressive from a scale point of view, I think, in that song. We're using bookshelf speakers, and yet we're getting bass, God, semi-equivalent to floor standards. I think, again, that sort of song exposes the limitations of using a bookshelf speaker. We're kind of missing some low-end presence that you would get. For example, if I had the Kef referencing in there, you're missing that low-end presence. And what the modern audio engineers have tried to do, they've tried to get a lot of bass out of these speakers, which works because you get a lot of bass out of them. But I think at the expense of a little bit of tightness and a little bit of articulation and control, when you compare them to something like the Bowers & Wilkins 705 S2s, which are about half the money, they don't have that harmonic content. The Bowers & Wilkins, don't have the harmonic content that the Platinums are going to give you, but they do have more of a nimble sort of bass. It's a more tight and boppy sort of bass, where these are more wallop sort of bass, bigger kind of bass. It obviously depends on preference, depends on your room. I don't really have any of those issues in this room because of the treatment and because of Dirac Live. So I can appreciate both different types, but most people don't have an acoustically treated room. You should be using Dirac Live. If you're not, you should be using it because that helps you control the sound, manage the sound. That way you get the sound that you want as opposed to the sound the room gives you. Anyway, if you're not using that, then you might need to tailor the output of the speakers. So these are going to give you a lot of bass. So bear that in mind, thinking, right, I'm going to stick these monitor audio platinums in a small room. Be warned, they're going to give you a lot of bass. So a small room, especially if you sit on a back wall, you're going to get a load of bass bloom, which is the problems I was having in here years ago with the Mark 1s. It's just bloomy bass. Now that is this room. This room has got a terrible peak at about 60 hertz. So all I was getting was bass heavy, horrible to listen to. As you can hear, exactly the same room. Don't get that problem anymore. But taking all those factors away, I think the Platinums are, they're a piece of furniture. They're a statement piece, speakers-wise. They're a piece of furniture. The finishes on them are absolutely lovely. And I'll always remember the Platinums that I had, the Mark 1s. I contacted Monitor Audio when I bought the centre speaker. I wasn't quite happy with something, and they fixed it straight away. And the service they gave me was outstanding. It's a service I've never experienced from a speaker company before. I was blown away by it. So they look after their customers, which is another really great thing about them. So yeah, hope you've enjoyed that song. That sort of music's not going to be for everybody, but look at it as a test. That's putting these under immense pressure. And I say, you've seen the little clip of just how much the drivers are going. So I think they're going that hard in order to do the bass. They've then got to try and do the mid-range, keep the mid-range in tow. And I suppose the Air Motion Tweeter or whatever it is, and now I need to look that up. The name should know that. Obviously, it's probably dropping down into the bass now, into the mid-range, sorry. And that is where you get kind of, a limitation with how these speakers present intense music like that. I think if it was a bigger speaker with more drivers, then it would be a more effortless presentation. But we've got to factor in size, cost, what you do get for the money. And these are probably going to be speakers for a lot of people. There'll be a lot of audiophiles out there really love a pair of these. And they do make really good home cinema system speakers as well. Lovely things to look at. Kind of a lot of pride of ownership with them. And they're lovely speakers. So hope you've enjoyed this little three-parter as song demonstrations. Obviously, the full review will be coming really soon for Monitor Audio Platinum PL Mark II, PL100 Mark IIs. And there's loads of other content in our channel. There's loads of great articles and stuff on our website. Make sure you go and visit that. And I'll be back to see you soon. Subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe. And a big thanks to Nintronics, obviously, for loaning us a sample for review. I keep forgetting to thank them. But I can't thank them enough. because they really support me in doing this. Obviously, it allows me to do this better for you guys. So, you know, make sure you go and speak to them if you're interested in buying some Mordio Platinums, especially as they've got some stock of the Rosewoods at a really ridiculously cheap price. If there's any left, they might all be gone. But if there's any left, you're interested in them, now's the best time to buy. Cool, I'll see you soon. Take care. Thanks for watching. Bye.